I talk, you listen. Welcome to my one-man panel of madness. Hey everyone, it's Dr. Gio Hu, and I hope you had a good, great, and awesome, safe Thanksgiving. If you celebrate Thanksgiving, I don't know, maybe you don't, maybe you're somewhere else in the world that doesn't celebrate Thanksgiving. But you should always celebrate something to be thankful for. Just saying. It's a little bit of Dr. Gio Hu's wisdom. Anyways, I am very thankful because we now have a one-minute-ish trailer for Doctor Who Revolution of the Daleks, and we now know that it is officially going to be New Year's Day 2021. Now, I'm going to start with that because originally I really felt like it was going to be a Christmas special. I thought because of the current crisis in the world that we would need a little bit more for our festive season. But good thing I didn't put any money down on that or bet on it because I was wrong. And the reason I said that was back when more information was coming through and we had the first little teaser glimpse with Captain Jack Harkness, even Radio Times was putting, which is, you know, a company of the BBC, was posting that, you know, this Christmas special, blah, blah, blah. Anyway, so obviously it's not a Christmas special. It is a New Year's Day special. Now, like I said, I'm kind of torn because I really wanted it to be a Christmas special, but hey, it's Doctor Who, and let's start 2021 with a bang. We've had two previous years now at New Year's. I'm okay. So I got over it. I got over the whining. Now, the trailer. Yes, wow. It's hard for me to put into words because it happened so fast that I didn't get a chance to really dive into it. But just listening to Captain Jack, I think, and maybe a lot of fans will agree on this, I think that that's what really just brought it home. It's Captain Jack Harkness, you know? So, you know, I think that that just in itself brought it more sort of, I'm not saying it's not legitimate Doctor Who, but it gave it more power, I think, because the few words that he says, traveling with the Doctor, you know, you just think back immediately on David Tennant as the 10th Doctor and those storylines and that sort of, you know, the Russell T era. So yeah, I'm very excited. I think it shows promise. I'm not going to get super excited because I don't know what's going to happen. We do know that it is going to be a 70-minute episode. So it is a feature-length episode. Yes, because we need our Doctor Who. We need it more than ever during these times. And it looks interesting. It's just, you know, I wanted to make sure that it's not just a whole episode and then the Doctor comes in at the end and saves the day. You know, there really has to be a lot more going on. Obviously, she's been in jail for who knows how long. Obviously not enough to regenerate. So, you know, again, time is wibbly wobbly. So on planet Earth, as the fam is doing whatever they're doing, with the Daleks, you know, she could be in jail. She could have been in jail for almost, you know, close to her regeneration. I don't know, but that's just something I'm thinking because, you know, we can have the Doctor live somewhere off for a million years. And for us, when she comes back to our time, it would have only been, what, 30 days maybe? But she would have already aged a million years. I know, it's all the science and the the physics of all this. But yes, I'm trying to think that maybe she has been in jail for a very long time, and this could age her enough that, who knows? And now, there are reports that she is not, and by she, I mean Jodie Whittaker, is in no mood to move on from Doctor Who. As a matter of fact, I think she's holding on to the role for a while. She stated in an interview that she hasn't been looking for any other work. So, you know, I've said in the past, I like Jodie Whittaker. I like the different energy that it brings to Doctor Who. And that's what Doctor Who has always been about. Different energy, different vibes. Are all her stories perfect and great? Absolutely not. I don't think they all are. There are some hits and some misses. But that's almost with every Doctor. So, the Daleks. Let's talk about the Daleks. We saw a few days ago that they showed the new Daleks, and we know that these are essentially a, I guess you could say, a more spiffier version of the ones we saw in the New Year's special 2 years ago. Instead of being all metallic and rusty, no pun intended, they're brand new. I like the design. I'm not gonna, you know, say that, oh, this is bad. It's not, you know, obviously for me, it'll always go towards the classic, the classic look of the Daleks. But this new version that we see, I actually quite like it. It's, I'll say this, it's a lot better than what we got from Stephen Moffat when he had the five, new Daleks that he created, the progenitors, I think is what they were called, the five Dalek leaders. I didn't like those at all. I didn't like them at all. And there are various types of Daleks. If you've ever watched a classic series, especially Remembrance of the Daleks, you see like the battle Daleks and you know, white Daleks, black Daleks. It's there's different kinds. But these look very cool. I like the coloring. They have that kind of sort of neon bluish white, almost like the TARDIS, a little lighter lighting than the TARDIS. And they obviously do give the impression that somehow Chris Noth's character, which we saw in Arachnids in the UK, who is coming back for the festive episode, somehow got his hands on a Dalek, or I don't know. Somehow I think that the Dalek from that episode is, and they said that there is, this is kind of a sequel to that very first episode we had, the very first, actually, now that I think about it, it is the first. We haven't had a New Year's. This would be the second one. Oh my goodness, I thought we had three New Year's. I am bad. My mind is gone. Sorry, folks. It's the season, and I don't do a lot of thinking. Plus, I'm also in the middle of a study program right now, so my mind is elsewhere. But yes, I think this is the only first, the second festive episode that we have with Jodie Whittaker. What am I thinking of? Why am I thinking this is the third one? I'm like, wait a second. What was the third one? Sorry. Anywho, I digress. So I'm very excited. I really like where this idea might be going. The other thing that I caught in the trailer that just really hit me was, besides all the other things that fans are finding out within the first few seconds of the trailer, seeing weeping angels and stuff like that, in the prison where the doctor is that the fam is somehow gathering inside what looks to me a TARDIS. And I could be wrong, but I've been watching that over and over. And I'm like, wait a second, they're inside a TARDIS. And it looks like, what are we calling it? The Ruth Doctor's TARDIS? You know, unless somehow Captain Jack has procured a TARDIS? Maybe he found a TARDIS? I don't know. So there's so many questions leading up to New Year's Day 2021. So very excited. There's a lot of cool stuff coming up. I'm sure there's a lot more that we're going to talk about as we get closer to New Year's Day 2021. But, you know, we have a lot of celebrations going. So there's a lot in between us. And let's enjoy it. You know, we are still dealing with a lot of crap out there because of this pandemic. You know, some people being selfish, other people not being selfish, people trying to be with family, which is understandable. Some people just don't care anymore. But, you know, we really have to start making sure that this doesn't keep spreading and keeps going further into the year 2021. Because, let's be honest, the whole 2020 was pretty much a wash. We had months there of uncertainty. People have been laid off. People haven't worked. And there's a lot of stuff going on out there. A lot of suffering. So, you know, try to be kind to each other. As the doctor always says, kind. Be kind. Kindness first. And just remember that wearing masks and stuff like that is not about you. Okay, it's about protecting others. A lot of people have symptoms, they don't know about it, and they spread it. And I have a lot of friends and family who are not well, and if they were to get the virus, they would pass. So that's a little bit more wisdom from Dr. Jiahu. And, you know, let's all take care of each other so we can make 2021 a good year. And, yeah, let's get ready for some Doctor Who. All right.